In question 19, we have two masses. They are connected by light rod, and the system is slipping down a rough incline of angle theta with the horizontal. We need to find acceleration of system and the force by the rod on one of the blocks. So this is the 19th one. Let's draw the free body diagram. So one basic diagram will be of the inclined plane. So M1, M2, two masses with a rod. Acceleration, let's say downward. Inclination angle theta. Now let's draw the free body diagram for both these objects, both these bodies. So R1, R2 reaction forces, M1g weight, M2g then tension, then frictional force and acceleration in this direction. And for this, along with tension, we have friction and acceleration. So now we have R1 equal to M1g cos theta, because this is M1g cos theta, as this is theta. Similarly for this, R2 is M2g cos theta. Then tension M1g sin theta minus M1a minus mu R1 equal to 0. M1g sin theta, M2g sin theta. And here M2 minus M2a M2g sin theta minus M2a plus mu R2 equal to 0. Here the friction should be downward like this, because the object is moving up. So opposite to the friction. So with these four equations, we can find the values. So the value for acceleration will be g sin theta minus mu cos theta. So this will be the acceleration of the blocks. Now the force exerted by rod on one of the blocks can be given by tension T equal to minus M1g sin theta plus M1a plus mu M1g sin theta. When you put further values, M1g sin theta, mu g cos theta plus mu M1g cos theta. So once you put the value of all these values, acceleration and all, acceleration's value is this much. So this becomes 0 because everything cancels out. In question 20, block of mass M is kept on rough horizontal surface. The block is to be pulled by applying a force. What is the minimum force needed to slide the block, and in what direction should the force act? So this is the 20th question. So let the free body diagram look something like this. Normal force, weight, let's say resultant or the applied force, and mu r angle is theta. So from this r plus p sine theta minus mg equal to 0, so from this r will be minus p sine theta, or mg plus mg minus p sine theta. And another equation is mu r. From here you can see that this will be p cos theta and this will be p sine theta. So mu r equal to p cos theta. So by these two equations we can find the value, putting the value of r here. And when you simplify this, you will find that mu mg equal to mu rho mu p sine theta minus p cos theta. So p will come out to be mu mg over mu sine theta plus cos theta. Now we need applied force to be minimum, so it is p is minimum when denominator, that is mu sin theta plus cos theta, is maximum. So for anything to be minimum or maximum, we differentiate with the changing factor, that is theta is here. So its differentiation must be equal to 0 in order to get a maxima or a minima. So ultimately we will obtain this after differentiation. Differentiation of sine is cos and differentiation of cos is minus sine. So from here theta is tan inverse mu. So p mu mg over mu sin theta plus cos theta. Let's divide this by cos theta. So mu mg over cos theta over mu sin theta over cos theta plus cos theta over cos theta. So we'll obtain mu mg sec theta, because 1 by cos theta is sec theta, and here mu tan theta and plus 1. On further simplification, we find that mu mg sec theta over mu is tan theta. Okay, mu is tan theta. So tan theta into tan theta will be tan theta square. Mu is tan theta. So this is what we have till now. Now let's simplify it further. Mu mg sec theta over mu square plus 1, this can also be there. Okay, so minimum force can be this value at an angle theta equal to tan inverse mu. In question 21, coefficient of friction between board and floor is mu. We need to find maximum force that the man can exert on the rope so that the board does not slip on the floor. 21st question. So let's draw the free body diagram. So tension is upward, normal force weight downward. On the block, reaction force weight and the reaction force of man m1r, or we can write mu r1. So ultimately let T be the maximum force that can be exerted. So r plus t equal to mg. So r is equal to mg minus t, and r1 minus r minus mg equal to 0. So r1 equal to r plus mg, and t minus mu r1 equal to 0. So from here t minus mu r1 is r plus mg equals 0. So after simplifying, mg plus t minus mu mg equal to 0, putting the value of r. So this t will become mu m plus m into g over 1 plus mu. So this will be the maximum tension or maximum force. In question 22, 2 kg block is placed over 4 kg block and both are placed on smooth horizontal surface. We need to find acceleration of two blocks if horizontal force of 12 Newton is applied to the upper block and then to the lower block. This is the 22nd question. Scenario is somewhat like this. Two blocks are there, 4 kg, 2 kg block. Let's draw the free body diagrams for them. Reaction force. Twelve Newton, 4A, 2A, 4G, 2G, mu R1, 2G, 2A, 0.2 R1. So these are the things that we have. So the equations are R1 minus 2G equal to 0. So R1 equal to 2G, that is 20 Newton. Also 2A plus 0.2 R1 minus 12 equal to 0. So from here A will be 4 meter per second square. Now apart from that, on the second diagram we have this thing. So we get A1 equal to 1 meter per second square. So 2 kg block has acceleration of 4 and 1 kg has the acceleration of 1 meter per second. 2 kg has this much acceleration, 4 kg mass has this much acceleration. Now in the second scenario, R1 is 2G equal to 20, MA minus mu R1 equal to 0, and 4A plus 0.2 into 2 into 10 minus 12 equal to 0. So here A will be 2 meter per second square, and here A will come out to be 2 meter per second square. So same for both. In question 23, we need to find accelerations A1, A2, A3. Now the values are given and there are three scenarios. So the situation is this, 1, 2, 3. So this is 2 kg, this is 3 kg, this is 7 kg. Coefficient of friction is different, 0.2. 0.3, 0.5, A, B, and C. Now there are different situations. In one situation we apply force on A, one situation we apply force on B, and in one situation we apply force on C. So let's first take the situation in which applying the force on A. Okay. So in the scenario, the free body diagram will be approximately like this. Weight mu R1, which will be 4 Newton. Next, डाउनवर्ड फोर्स 10 न्यूटन, 3G वेट एंड नॉर्मल रिएक्शन 5G, दिस इज 15 न्यूटन। सो द इक्वेशंस विल बी समवॉट लाइक दिस। सो म्यू आर वन विल बी 4 न्यूटन फ्रॉम द 3 kg ब्लॉक। सो फॉर द 3 kg एंड फॉर 2 kg ब्लॉक नेट फोर्स विल बी 10 - 4, दैट इज 6 न्यूटन। सो एक्सेलरेशन विल बी 6/2, दैट इज 3 m/s² मास, फोर्स अपॉन मास। बट ब्लॉक 3 kg, ब्लॉक ऑफ 3 kg, द फ्रिक्शनलेस फोर्स फ्रॉम 2 kg ब्लॉक बिकम्स ड्राइविंग फोर्स एंड मैक्सिमम फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स बिटवीन 3 kg एंड 7 kg कैन बी फाउंड आउट। मैक्स फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स बिटवीन 3 kg एंड 7 kg, म्यू टू आर टू इक्वल टू 0.3 × 5 इक्वल टू 15 न्यूटन। नाउ 3 kg ब्लॉक कैन नॉट मूव रिलेटिव टू 7 kg ब्लॉक, बोथ विल मूव इन सेम डायरेक्शन विद सेम एक्सेलरेशन। सो लेट्स से A2 A3, एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ ए 3 kg ब्लॉक एंड 7 kg ब्लॉक इज सेम एंड इट विल कम आउट टू बी 4/10, 0.4 m/s², सेम फॉर बोथ द ब्लॉक्स। नाउ बी पार्ट, नाउ 10 न्यूटन इज अप्लाइड ऑन थ्री के जी ब्लॉक। सो इन दिस सिचुएशन मैक्स फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स दैट इट कैन फील विल बी 15 + 4, 19 न्यूटन फ्रॉम 2 kg एंड 7 kg ब्लॉक एंड इट कैन नॉट मूव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू देम एंड द फ्लोर इज फ्रिक्शनलेस सो द एक्सेलरेशंस विल बी सेम 10/12, 5/6 m/s². In the third scenario, when you apply 10 newton to 7 kg block, so in this scenario, all three blocks will again move together 5/6 m/s². In question 24, friction coefficient between two blocks is mu. We need to find maximum horizontal force that can be applied without disturbing the equilibrium of system. Suppose horizontal force applied is double that of found in part A. What will happen? Find the acceleration of two masses. So this is the scenario that is given. So this is 24th. So here what we have is normal reaction force, tension, frictional force, net force, weight, and on another body reaction force, tension, mu r, mg, r1, friction mu r1. So R1 is equal to mg from the first diagram. It is quite simple. F minus mu R1 minus T equal to 0. So F equal to mu mg plus mu mg. Tension is equal to mu mg. So ultimately force is 2 mu mg. Next situation, the free body diagrams will look something like this. so it will like be like mg t mu r 1 ma 2f r 1 acceleration ma mu r 1 t mg r 1 r and acceleration in this direction. So 2f minus t mu mg minus ma equal to 0, t minus ma minus mu mg equal to 0, t equal to ma minus ma plus mu mg. Two f minus ma mu mg minus ma equal to 0, putting the value of t from here. So after we put other values as well, we find something like this. We know f is 2 mu mg. So ultimately acceleration will be 2 mu mg over small capital M into small m. It's capital M plus small m. So both the blocks move with this acceleration in opposite direction. Suppose the in question 25, suppose the entire system of reverse question is kept in elevator which is coming down with acceleration less than g. We again need to find a and b. 25th, r1 mg ma tension t mu r1 force f, acceleration is downward, and again mg r1 ma and r2 tension t mu r1. So ultimately from here r1 plus ma minus mg equal to 0 and t minus mu r1 equal to 0, so it will be t equal to m mu mg minus ma. Or like this, mg minus ma, because r1 is mg minus ma. Now after this we also know from the second diagram this equation. So f minus mu mg minus ma, putting the value minus mu mg minus ma equal to 0. So once we open this, this will be 2 mu mg minus 2 mu ma, so force will be twice of mu m g minus a. Now second situation, acceleration of block, let's say it is a1. So again r2 ma acceleration a1 tension net force friction weight normal force weight normal reaction friction net force to twice force that is applied acceleration and ma. So from this we have this particular equations टी माइनस म्यू आर वन माइनस एम ए वन इक्वल टू ज़ीरो, सो टी कम्स आउट टू बी म्यू एम जी माइनस म्यू एम ए प्लस एम ए वन। And from here 2f minus t minus mu r1 minus ma1 equal to 0. So using all the values we find that this 2f minus t minus mu mg plus mu a minus ma1 equal to 0. Now subtracting f and t, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Subtracting 1 and 2, we get 2 mu m g minus a 2 mu m g mu m a m a 1 minus mu m g plus mu m a minus mu a 1 equal to 0. So from here ultimately after solving you will get a 1 to be this much. Both blocks will move with this acceleration in opposite direction. In question 20, we have to consider figure 6 E9. Suppose small electric field E exists in space in vertically up direction and upper block carries positive charge Q on its top surface. Frictional coefficient is mu. We need to find maximum horizontal force that can be applied without disturbing the equilibrium. So this is 26th question. So the scenario is something like this. Small m force attached with a pulley and electric field is in this direction which is applying F equal to QE and let's draw the free body diagrams. So this is for small m, this is for capital M. So mg QE force downward, tension, frictional force, normal force, net force, tension, frictional force, normal force, weight, normal force. So from this R1 plus QE minus mg equal to 0. R1 equal to mg minus QE. This is equation 1. Then F minus T minus mu R1 equals 0. So F minus T mu mg minus QE equal to 0. Putting the value of R1. So T mu R1 equal to 0. So T will be mu R1 and it can be mu mg minus QE. So tension comes out to be mu mg minus mu QE. So now we know that F minus mg minus mu QE minus mu mg plus mu c QE is equal to 0. So this means F minus 2 mu mg plus 2 mu QE. So F equal to 2 mu mg minus QE. So this will be the maximum horizontal force that can be applied. In question 27, block of mass M slips on rough horizontal table under the action of horizontal force applied to it. Coefficient of friction is mu. Table does not move on the floor. We need to find total frictional force applied to the floors on the legs of the table. this is 27th one. Now let's say this is our table scenario is this. Now box R M F mu R1 and then mg r mu r. So ultimately r is equal to mg f minus mu r equal to 0, f equal to mu r equal to mu mg. And now this table is addressed, so frictional force on the leg is not mu r1. So let the frictional force be mu naught minus mu r equal to 0. So f naught mu r equal to mu mg. So total frictional force will be mu mg. In question 20, we need to find acceleration of the block of mass m in figure 6E10. So this is 28th. So now the situation something like this. So now the free body diagram will be mg tension r1 ma, and the friction will be also upward mu 1 r1, and another on another body mg mu 2 r2 ma r1 mu 1 r1 r2 and tension t. So from all this we have following equations: R1 minus MA equal to 0, R1 is equal to MA. And 2MA plus T minus MG plus mu1 R1 equal to 0. So T will be MG minus 2 minus mu1 MA. This is equation 2, this is equation 1. And from the second free body diagram, we have this scenario: mg minus r2 equal to 0. So r2 becomes t plus mu1 ma plus mg. So ultimately mg minus 2 ma minus mu1 ma plus mu1 ma plus mg. So ultimately r2 will become mg minus plus mg minus 2ma. Let this be equation 3. And from the second free body diagram again, we have this scenario as well. So the scenario seems something like this: putting the value of r2. So we find 2t equal to m plus m 2a plus mu 2 mg plus mg minus 2ma. Let this be equation 4. So by equation 2 and 4, 2t equals 2mg minus 2 into 2 plus mu 1 mg. And after simplifying everything, you will find that acceleration is 2m minus mu 2 m plus m इंटू जी ओवर एम प्लस एम, फाइव प्लस टू म्यू वन माइनस म्यू टू। इन क्वेश्चन 29 अ ब्लॉक ऑफ मास 2 केजी इज पुश्ड अगेंस्ट अ रफ वर्टिकल वॉल विद सम फोर्स। नाउ विल द ब्लॉक मूव इफ यस इन विच डायरेक्शन, इफ नो देन फाइंड द फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स एक्सर्टेड बाय द वॉल एंड द ब्लॉक। 29th सो द नेट फोर्स विल बी लाइक दिस, सो इट विल बी अराउंड, इट्स लाइक दिस एक्चुअली, सो इट विल बी अराउंड 25 माइनस 20 इक्वल टू 5 न्यूटन। दिस इज एक्चुअली 5, सो इट विल बी 25 माइनस 35 माइनस 20 15 न्यूटन। नाउ 10 थीटा विल बी 20 ओवर 15, दैट इज 4 बाय 3, सो म्यू विल बी 10 इनवर्स 4 बाय 3, दैट इज थीटा विल बी 53 डिग्री। In question 30, a person of 40 kg is managing to be at rest between two vertical walls by pressing one wall A by his hand, and let's assume the frictional coefficient between his body and wall is 0.8. So we need to show that person pushes the two walls with equal force and find the normal force exerted by either wall on the person. Okay. So this is 30th question. So let's say this is a scenario that we have, now the person is applying force like this, so normal force R weight downward 40 G. So mass is given 50 kg, acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. Now ultimately frictional force will be developed between hands, legs and backside, and he gives equal force on both the walls, so gets equal reaction from both the walls. So ultimately the mu r plus mu r, these two frictional forces will keep it up, okay, will keep it up, and it will be equal to 40 g. oh, this is 40 kg, so 40 g, because mu r and mu r frictional forces, so ultimately 2 mu r equal to 40 into 10. So R will come out to be 40 into 10 over 2 into 0.8. So R will be equal to 250 Newton. This will be the reaction force, normal force. So the normal force will be 250 Newtons. In question 31, a figure is given. The system is started towards right with initial velocity V. We need to find the time elapsed before the smaller block separates from the bigger block. So this is 31st question. So the scenario is something like this. There is one block, another block, mass M, A1 acceleration, A2 acceleration, length is L. So now let's draw the free body diagrams. R, A1, M plus M, G, A2, this is normal force, like this. Weight is mg. Now here the acceleration is ma2, and mu by 2 mg is also there, and mu m plus m into g is also there, normal force, frictional force, and mu by 2 r is there, reaction force r. So from this we will find that what do we have. We have m a1 plus mu by 2 r equal to 0, m a1 equal to minus mu by 2, r is mg, so it will be minus mu by 2 m into 10. So we will obtain a1 to be equal to minus 5 mu. And again similarly from other diagrams, ma2 plus mu mm g minus mu by 2 mg equal to 0. So 2 ma2 plus 2 mu m plus m g minus mu mg equal to 0. So a2 will be equal to minus mu mg minus 2 mu capital mg over 2 m. So ultimately we know that for m to separate from capital M, vt plus half at square, or ut plus half at square, must be equal to ut plus half a2 t square plus l. So by putting all the values in this, t will be root 4 ml over m plus m mu g.